All right, we are going to bring you two sprinting drills to help you sprint faster. And these ones are really more specifically going to help you focus on staying more front side with your mechanics, your sprint side, all right? So focusing on the knee lift, what's happening in front of your body as opposed to the back side, so you can sprint faster, all right? So two things that we really need to combat that, because the better sprinters are more front side dominant, is one is like a plate punch, all right? And so all you really need is a plate. You can use a med ball, just maybe 5 or 10 pounds, nothing too crazy. And then all this is gonna do is kind of reflexively engage your core, so that way when you're sprinting, good things automatically happen where you don't have to think about it, all right? So as a coach, a lot of times I try to prescribe drills where the less you think, the better you're gonna do, especially when it comes to sprinting, okay? First drill is really the plate punch with a knee drive, all right? So all we're gonna do is start with the chest on, start with the A-skip rhythm, okay? And then what's gonna happen is, as soon as I wanna bring my knee up, I'm gonna punch the weight out in front, and then I'm gonna return it back to where I started, all right? And the goal is just to be quick and make sure I hit those positions. So when I'm here and I'm bouncing, I punch my knee and the plate out at the same time. And then that's automatically just gonna sling your body forward, and you should feel yourself kind of travel horizontally if you're doing it right, okay? When you punch the weight out, when you punch your knee forward, you're gonna feel your body slide forward, almost like getting pulled, okay? And that is a good thing because you're actually covering ground, what you wanna do when you sprint. One quick coaching cue for you guys when you're doing this drill is you wanna make sure you hit your positions, all right? So what I mean by that is when I do my plate punch, I wanna make sure I'm getting my knee up where I need to be when I actually mimic sprinting, okay? So I don't want you to do a plate punch and have your knee up, be all the way down here. So you need to do it with full force and intent to get the most out of the drill, okay? So we gotta make sure we get to that sprinter position and get back out of it quickly, all right? So that's just a big mistake I see a lot of guys make, just going through the motion with the drill. Don't do that, all right? Second one for you guys is simply a med ball high knee run. So again, you can use a plate if you want. Med ball would be great. I believe I stole this one from Ken Joss and DeFranco, so check him out, it's really legit. So we can do it. All we're gonna do is hold the med ball roughly belly button height, where we kind of want our knee to finish. And we're gonna basically do a high knee run, and we're gonna think about kneeing underneath the ball, so getting our knee up, hitting the ball. Obviously our arms are pushing down, so you get a little core activation. And we're just doing a med ball knee punch run, all right? So grab the med ball, hold it nice and stiff, good posture, and then we're just gonna pop our knees underneath the ball. Stay in, you should feel yourself bouncing and floating, getting off the ground, all right? So that's just another drill to help you teach to get your thigh pop forward, stay more front side, and help you sprint faster. So drills you can use today for you guys. For sets and reps with the plate punch drill, you just need to do maybe 5 to 10 reps max per leg, 2 sets. For the med ball high knee run, start with the distance, you know, 10 yard sprint, focusing on obviously more contact. So we're not trying to go the 10 yards really fast. We're trying to get as many contacts as we can, and just to rehearse that motor pattern to get our thighs up, right? So maybe 2 sets of 10 yards just to start programming ourselves to sprint faster, right? So if you like this video, hit a like, hit a subscribe, super appreciate that. And there's also a link down below if you would like this video and you want to improve your sprint technique. There's a free cheat sheet I put together. Go ahead, hit the link, and I will email it to your inbox today for you guys. Appreciate you. We'll be right back.